is next we are going to see with the magnetic effect of current. Okay, so how the current plays as a major role in the magnet, that is what we are going to see. And it was on 21st April, Hans Christian Oster, a Danish physicist, what he did is he did a lecture. Okay, he was giving a lecture and he was demonstrating electrical circuits in that class. Okay, so during that class what he did is he was demonstrating with the electrical circuit. So this is a battery and this is a key, so how it works, all that he was demonstrating. He had to off and switch on and off the circuit during the lecture. So what he had to do is there will be a switch, is it not? That switch has to be on, off, often. Okay, accidentally he noticed that the needle of the magnetic compass was on the table. Okay, so he noticed that some needle, and that needle of the magnetic compass was on the table. Okay, and it deflected whenever he switched on the current, and the current was flowing through the wire. Okay, so whenever he switched on, what it does is it deflected. Okay, so if this is a magnet and this is a compass, what it did, it deflected. And whenever he switched off, what it did is it come back to the same position. So like that it was happening. The compass needle moved only slightly so that the audience didn't even notice, but it was clear that something significant was happening. And so he conducted many experiments to find the startling effect, and that was said to be the magnetic effect. Okay, so nothing but whenever there is a current flow, okay, there will be magnetic field which is felt. Okay, so Oster aligned a wire XY. So this is a wire which is XY, where exactly along the north-south direction. So it was assumed to be along the north-south direction. He kept one magnetic compass above the wire at A. Okay, so above this, but one point he kept a magnetic compass and another magnetic compass at the point B. Okay, and when the circuit was open, so when the circuit is open, there is no current which is flowing. So if the current flow illa na enagudhu, this will not show any deflection. So adha first paathom illaya. So if the current flow illa na, it will not have any deflection. If there is current flow, it will deflect. Okay, so no current was flowing and the needle was pointing to the north. So north direction le irundhathu. Okay, once the circuit was closed, an electric current was flowing. So idha circuit vandu close panitom, ipo enna agudhu, current flow irukku. So ipdi current flow irukumbodhu enna agum, indha magnet vandu deflect aagum. Okay, so and A will be point towards the east and B point towards the west. Okay, so this shows that the current carrying conductor produces the magnetic field. So whenever you have the current carrying conductor, it produces a magnetic field. So this is a concept which is based on this magnetic effect of current. Yeah, so the direction of magnetic lines around the current carrying conductor can be easily understood using the right hand thumb rule. So how the direction of magnetic field, that is understood with the help of the right hand thumb rule. Hold the wire with four fingers of your right hand and thumb with the position facing upward. Okay, so here, so this is a wire if you are considering. Okay, so this is a wire and all the four fingers are being bent and the thumb alone is being pointing towards the upward direction. Okay, if the direction of the current is towards the thumb, so thumb side la the direction of current a irundhuchana, then the magnetic lines curl in the same direction as your four fingers. So other four fingers in the direction la irukku, and the side la da enna irukku, magnetic field irukum. Okay, so it is nothing but ipo this is the direction of the current, then this will be the direction of magnetic field. So that is what right hand thumb rule. This shows that the magnetic field is always perpendicular to the direction of current. Okay, so magnetic field um direction of current um eppadi irukku, perpendicular a irukku appdi solirukka. Okay, so next we see with the strength of the magnetic field, it depends on few things. Okay, so what are the things that strength of the magnetic field depends on? Is first one the current, next is the distance, orientation and the magnetic nature. Okay, so these are the things that the magnetic field depends on. Current in the wire, so how much current is flowing. Next is distance of the point from the wire. Okay, so from the wire, how much distance the point is. Okay, that distance. Next is orientation. So what is meant by orientation is that denotes the angle. Okay, so angle at which they are placed. Next is the magnetic nature of the medium. So whatever medium they are considering, how the magnetic nature is. So these are the things the strength of the magnetic field depends on. Okay, so what are they? Current, distance of the point from the wire. Next is orientation, magnetic nature. Yes, clear with this?